I am so excited that summer is kicking off and I can break out my red, white, and blue decor. Today, I've got 6 new Dollar Tree DIYs for you, so stay tuned. They are easy to put together and they are so cute. I'm Whitney, this is Whiskey and Wit, and I love to share home decor and budget DIYs with you, as well as Cricut tips, wood builds, and just overall lifestyle content. So be sure to hit subscribe down below so you don't miss a future Whiskey and Wit video.
Up first, we're gonna make this super adorable ice cream banner. I have been loving the look of the red, white, and blue popsicles, or the bomb pops. I ended up seeing these wooden dominoes in my stash, but you could make this with a variety of different Dollar Tree items. This is just what I had on hand. You could use poster board for this. It would be cute with paper. You could also do something similar with the little tumbling tower block, so the sky's the limit. I went through and cut off the bottom of my little dominoes to create little popsicle shapes. Then once everything was cut out, I went through and painted them. I did red, white, and blue, and then I did some extra whites because that is how I ended up painting the bomb pops. You want to make sure that you get the edges of these. The back, it doesn't really matter because you won't see it, but the edges you will, as it hangs as a garland. To create the red, white, and blue popsicles, I just took a piece of 1-inch painter's tape and stuck it right down the center. I painted the bottoms blue and the tops red. Now this is just paint I had on hand. The color blue is actually Waverly chalk paint and the color ocean, which I will link all these details down below. And the top is flag red apple barrel acrylic paint. I just use those because that's what my other projects are and I wanted it to match my other patriotic decor. And what is a popsicle without a popsicle stick? So to add that, I just grabbed some Dollar Tree dowels, and depending on the size of your popsicles, if you make them bigger, you could probably use the Jenga blocks from Dollar Tree as well. I made sure to sand the rough edges, and then I took some hot glue and stuck them directly to the back of my little dominoes. Now I had to figure out a way to hang these popsicles from the garland, but I wanted them to be able to be moved. So instead of just gluing the twine on the back, I decided to make these loops. I just used some scrap felt and a little piece of the leftover dowel rod so that the loop didn't get glued down, and it worked out pretty well. Then you can use whatever twine you have, yarn, whatever. I just used this Dollar Tree cotton twine because I liked the white versus the jute color. And then I just strung them up, red, white, blue, and then a multicolored one. I also used some little wood bead spacers, but that's totally optional. I just liked the look. And here they are. I love these popsicles. You will see them throughout the video. They became part of other projects as well, unintentionally, but I just thought they turned out so cute. This is such a fun little theme for decor. And also, I feel like the popsicle theme for patriotic is not super overdone, so it looks like something that not a lot of other people will have as well. Now, speaking of using those popsicles and other things, one project suggestion is making a cute little tiered tray sign like this. So I grabbed one of these small Dollar Tree signs. You could use whatever you can find at Dollar Tree. But the back is blank, so I just glued my little popsicle onto that, and this is going to be an awesome addition to my tiered trays for Memorial Day, 4th of July, all of my Americana decor needs. Another option is you can make a smaller garland. I made this one for my tiered tray, and I love how it gives some depth in an area where you really struggle because it's hard to fit stuff underneath there. I just taped it with some Scotch tape, and it really filled out that tiered tray. So a lot of different options. Now, if you follow me on Instagram, you saw that I shared this truck sign from Dollar Tree, and I was excited to find it. But if you look at it, it is glitter central, and that is just not my vibe. So I decided to make it over and make it into a little planter. So I started by popping off the 3D pieces for the different bumpers and fender, and then I peeled off all of the decorations on the front. That was a lot easier than sanding off the glitter, a lot less messy. I just made sure to score the part by the flag because I wanted to save that, but everything else could go because I knew that I wasn't going to really want the glitter all over the place. And it came off fairly easily. I was glad that it peeled instead of having to sand the whole thing down. I also repeated that for the bumper on both of the trucks, so then I had 4 bumpers and 2 trucks. I went through with just some white wood filler and filled the holes where the sign hung because I didn't want those to be prevalent when I put my piece together. Now, I ran into a slight problem because the trucks are the same. They're not mirrored image. And so I needed to make the truck a mirrored image. So I just took my jigsaw of one of them and cut off the flag so that I could flip it. And you'll see why I needed to do that in a little bit, but it was easy to get it off with my jigsaw. Now to create the planter portion and to hook it all together, I grabbed two Crafter Square crates, added some Gorilla wood glue that I just got from Walmart, and I stuck them together because you're not going to be putting anything too heavy in this or have it be a structural piece of the decor. It was easy to just put together the wood glue, and then after the wood glue dried, I went through and stained it with my favorite dark walnut. While the stain was drying, I went back inside with my two trucks and I painted them front and back with that flag red acrylic paint color. Then to paint the one where the flag was still attached, I just used some painter's tape so that I didn't get it icky, and then I made sure to also paint the fenders and all of the edges of the pieces. Then using the image of the original truck as a guide, I filled in the areas that I wanted. So I did two black tires, and then I took a pencil and kind of used the picture to draw in the door, the little bottom like foot area as you get into the truck, the bed piece, and then just a little line on the front. I liked that it was a lot more simple, and I thought about putting something on the door, but I liked how the flag was the focal piece instead of having USA on the door like the original piece. Then I just took some scrap dowels and some hot glue to rehook the flag, but in the opposite direction. I just eyeballed it so that it was directly across from the other flag. It's not going to be a mirror image, but it's pretty close. Then my last two steps were to outline the wheels as well as add some inner parts of the wheels to give it a little dimension. And I just used my Arteza little acrylic paint marker. It was a lot easier than using a paint brush. And then I just took some hot glue and attached my boxes flush with the bottom of the truck, not with the wheels, but the bottom of the actual truck itself, so that you kind of had some depth to it. I filled it with some of these Real Feel tulips that I recently got on sale at Kirkland's, and I really like this makeover. You can put whatever you want in the back. It would also be cute with some fireworks or some other florals. This is way more my style, especially ditching the glitter and going a little bit more simple, but the red is traditional Americana red, and I absolutely love how it looks with the other pieces that I've made in this video too. Now for this year for patriotic decor, I knew I wanted a blanket for my blanket ladder in my living room. However, everyone that I was finding that I loved was either super small or 50 bucks. Well, I found a way to make one that was huge like this that works great for what I needed it for under $10. So I saw these super cute scarves at Dollar Tree. This print is awesome. It is so my style. And so I decided to grab a few of those to put together. So I decided to use some things that I already had from last year in my house to finish off this patchwork. So these are from Target last year, same with the gingham, but the two blue ones are Dollar Tree. These are those scarves, and Dollar Tree also has, this year I've seen them, they've got flag bandanas. I've made pillows out of those. So there are a lot of different options, but basically I laid it all out and I decided to hook it together just with a blanket stitch. So that's what this looks like here. So to do the blanket stitch, you're going to want to pair up your two pieces of fabric where you want the seam to be. So I went ahead and did the three pieces that you're seeing on the bottom of your screen right now, but this is how I did it. So I lined up my scarf and I made sure that the two sides that you want as the back are matched up. So you want the two right sides out if you're thinking about like making a pillow. And then this is a super easy process to hook these two together. I do not have a sewing machine. I am not skilled in sewing, but this worked out really well. So I did a blanket stitch. So I just took a needle and yarn. I didn't even use thread because I wanted the yarn to show up. I tied a knot in the end of my yarn and I pulled it through one of the pieces. Then I paired them back up in the corner and put my needle through both of the pieces right in the same spot, just to start the process. Once I pulled that through, then I had a little loop, as you can see. And then I went about an inch over and went through both of the pieces again. Now to create the blanket stitch and give it a really pretty kind of white outline where you stitched, before you pull it all the way taut, you'll have this loop here, and you're going to take your needle and thread and pull it in the opposite direction that you just did. So because I went away from me through the fabric, I'm coming back towards me. So then once you do that, you'll get this little loop, and then you can continue on to go through both of the pieces, pull it through, you'll grab your loop, and then you'll go back through towards yourself through that loop. I continued on through all of the different pieces. I did two sets of three bandanas hooked together, and then I needed three scarves. So if you get the bandanas from Dollar Tree, they're two to a pack. So that is $3 for the square bandanas and then $3 for the scarves. These were in my basement, so it was even cheaper for me. But honestly, this worked out so perfect. It is huge. This is me with my wingspan. I'm also 5'11". I'm not a short person, and this pretty much covers me. So it works out super well for this little area in my living room where I wanted that blanket letter. Now you guys are never gonna guess what I made these firecrackers out of. I saw something similar on Pinterest and I wanted to make them, and I thought there's probably no way I can make a Dollar Tree because they're wood dowels, but then I remembered I had a plunger from DT in my basement. Now these are awesome dowel rods, and I've never actually cut them apart. That's why I originally bought this, and I had another idea and I didn't end up using it. So what I did is removed the end of the plunger, and I figured out how long it was minus the little handle that has the grooves in it. I went through and marked 4 inches, 5 inches, and 6 inches. And then you could use your miter box if you have that, but because we already had our saw out for another project, I just quickly went through and cut them. Now you wanna make sure you also cut off the two ends so that they are going to sit flat. The end of the plunger is kind of curved, and so you wanna make sure that that wood is flat so they all sit flat. Then I gave all three of them a coat of dark walnut by Minwax. And then taking some 1-inch painter's tape, I marked off the ends for the mid-sized one to make that white. The smaller one was going to be blue, so I did about the center for that, and I did the same thought process for the large one for the red. But you could do whatever you want. You could add stars to this. I just really like the kind of vintage, simple look. The red and the white needed two coats because the blue is chalk paint. It only needed one. And then once it's dry, I just peeled off my painter's tape and had my three little fireworks. Then I just took some scrap nautical rope. I pulled the pieces apart and glued it to the top. I liked that better than jute twine because, as you can see here, it will stand straight up versus the jute twine falling over, and it's a little thicker. And finally, it wouldn't be a patriotic video for me if I didn't make some sort of wreath. And this one has to be one of my favorite patriotic ones I have made to date. I ended up taking this Dollar Tree wreath form and wrapping it with some nautical rope for a peony video a couple weeks ago. I will link that if you missed it and need to know how to put together that actual base. But because the peonies didn't really work in a certain part of my house, I ended up repurposing it. So I took this USA sign from Dollar Tree and peeled off the glitter like I did for the trucks, and that was a pretty easy process. Once I took everything off, I gave it a quick sand with a sanding block to make sure there weren't any random pieces sticking up. And then I painted the S white. I painted the U red and the A blue. So for USA, it was red, white, and blue in that order. Then once those were dry, I laid them out onto my wreath form and hot glued them down, slightly overlapping. And then I was going to use that white star in the right-hand corner, but I decided to actually forego that because in between painting those and putting it together, I had ran to another Dollar Tree and found this really cute yard stake. And so I thought this would be awesome for this wreath. So I just took a flathead screwdriver. It took a little bit of elbow grease, but I was able to pop the stake off so that I could add some hot glue and glue it to my wreath. Then my last step was to figure out what to do in the right-hand corner, and popsicles to the rescue. I love how this turned out up in the corner. I ended up doing blue, white, red, then multicolor because the A and the blue truck were a lot of blue underneath. So to balance it out, I did blue towards the top. And then I just added some ribbon I had from a gift that my sister-in-law gave Finn. It was red, white, and blue ribbon, and I knew I would use it eventually. And so I just tied it so that I could hook it up. I love this wreath. I love that it has the brown kind of neutral background. I love the popsicles. I just love all of it. And this area is so fun in our living room now when you come in our front door. I need to get my other patriotic decor out, but I am loving it so far.
Thanks so much for watching. As always, let me know your favorite project down in the comments, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Bye!